Let's go back to the first video, wiring in electronic circuits. This is part two. Here I have made some remarks about wiring. I say here, for instance, that the length of the wiring doesn't matter on circuits up to 20 kilohertz. That is somewhat bold, but anyway, don't worry too much. For instance, it could be a problem when you have an amplifier, audio amplifier, that works on 0 up to 20 kilohertz, and you mount the input wiring, the sensitive input wiring, where all the signals come in at, say, 0.7 volts or so, very close to the output wiring to the loudspeakers. When such an amplifier starts to take current, so when an audio signal is applied at a certain level, the amplifier starts to amplify. That means that a high current to the loudspeakers flows, in this case, very directly to the sensitive input wiring. And that means that in such a case, an amplifier can start to oscillate. That's very important. So that's also a possibility. So when I say here that there is no influence from the length of the wiring, you have to take that with a grain of salt. Up to 12 megahertz in radios, I have already explained that in the earlier video. The wiring is also sub-important, again, because when you make an oscillator, the wiring gets very critical. And also, in an electronic circuit, we have all kinds of units combined together. For instance, here, a circuit from a preamplifier for a magnetodynamic element. We connect here to the preamplifier a power supply. And the power supply, a standard power supply with a transformer, a rectifier, and a supply capacitor, is in general not sensitive to oscillations. But here the voltage comes in, and then we have the circuit here. Also, this circuit here works from 0 up to 20 kilohertz. It's also not very sensitive for oscillations, though, that's very important to tell, it could be that such an amplifier starts to oscillate. It starts to hick, or it starts to motorboat, or it starts to yell. And in that situation, you can be sure that the decoupling is not properly made. This is the decoupling. In every electronic circuit, classical electronic circuit, you can see decoupling capacitor here, with this capacitor, and these two capacitors here prevent the circuit from oscillating when it is applied on long power supply lines. That's very important, and I've also made a few videos about this on my YouTube channel. But again, when we're talking about wiring, this is an issue. This regards preamplifiers, end amplifiers, etc., etc., prevent oscillation and all kinds of effects with the help of this decoupling unit. And it's even better here when you use here a resistor and connect the power supply here, a resistor first from say 500 ohms or 1 kilo ohm, and then supply such a unit. It prevents problems, many problems. And we also have to take in account, for instance, that when the earth wiring from such a circuit is not properly made, it can also start to hum or to oscillate. When there must be a proper connection here to the minus and it is not there, For instance, the minus lead goes to the chassis and then to the power supply. There is in fact no proper wire here. There is an uncertain wire in such a situation that can make that this preamplifier starts to oscillate. That's also an issue here when we talk about wiring. That's the earth wiring. That's also very important. So that was more or less part two from the video wiring in electronic circuits.